Welcome to Hybiz News. My name is Suresh Kochatan. If there is one thing that the world is desperately looking for now, it's a vaccine for the dreaded COVID-19. Any company that can move the idea from lab to a product to the market is likely to see billion-dollar business. Actually, more than a few billions. While many pharmaceutical companies are in the race to develop a vaccine for a virus that is killing people by the thousands and infecting lakhs, many are wondering who will get the first nod to produce a vaccine. Our exit strategy from the global lockdown depends on the development of an effective vaccine, as is well known. A huge effort is underway to find such a vaccine, but we cannot afford to wait for another 18 months that it might take. In the meantime, as the death toll increases, doctors are desperate for treatment that would lessen the impact of the virus by shortening the infection, reducing the severity, and in a way, saving lives. There is now a global hunt for a coronavirus drug, but it's a fight against time. The focus is therefore on existing treatments already proved to be safe for other diseases, which will need less testing and be much easier and quicker to manufacture in quantity. And the World Health Organization has identified some of the most promising therapies. These include an HIV combination treatment, an anti-malarial and a drug developed but never used for Ebola for testing in a global launch last month. But we cannot pause the search while waiting for the results. The need for new effective agents is too great. One Indian company, the Hyderabad-based Bharat Biotech, seems to be in the race to develop a vaccine. Bharat Biotech and the US-based Flugen, along with the virologists from the University of Wisconsin, Madison, have begun the development and testing of a unique vaccine against COVID-19 called CoroFlu. Ahmedabad-based Zydus Cadila and Pune-based Serum Institute are also in the race to develop the vaccine for COVID-19 from India. Last week, an artificial intelligence platform run by Gero, based in Singapore, identified 6 drugs already approved for human use in other conditions which could help combat COVID-19. Meanwhile, Thomas Siebel, the billionaire head of C3.ai, a Californian artificial intelligence agency company, announced a public-private partnership consortium including Princeton, Carnegie Mellon University, MIT, the Universities of California, Illinois, and Chicago, as well as C3.ai and Microsoft, which will provide scientists with the funding and access to some of the most world's advanced supercomputers in the search for the solutions to this pandemic. CoroFlu will be built on the backbone of Flugen's flu vaccine candidate known as M2SR. Based on an invention by University of Wisconsin, Madison, virologists and Flugen co-founders Yoshihiro Kawaoka and Gabriel Newman, the M2SR is a self-limiting version of the influenza virus that induces an immune response against the flu. Kawaoka's lab will insert the gene sequences from SARS-CoV-2, the novel coronavirus that causes the disease COVID-19, into M2SR so that the new vaccine will also induce immunity against the coronavirus. Chairman and Managing Director of Bharat Biotech, Dr. Krishna M. Ella, said that a lot depends on the approval process. If the government of India acts fast on it and treats it as a national emergency, it should be possible to get the vaccine in about 8 months, said Dr. Ella.
We are the first company to develop a pandemic flu in 2009. And also 2011, we developed the chikungunya vaccine. And again, we're the first company in the world to develop Zika vaccine before anybody has thought about that vaccine. So we have a history of developing various pandemic vaccine. With that background, we thought we should do something for corona also. So we've been looking at it the worldwide, what is the best technology that can fit in for a large population of 1.3 billion population that to reach a platform that can take care of the safety of the people and also delivery to the people of the country. So we found out Yoshihiro Kawaoka at University of Wisconsin, Madison is one of the top renowned virologists and also respiration pathologist and also influenza vaccine developer in the world. And he has developed a company called Flugen with a tripartite, with a Flugen at University of Wisconsin and Bharat Biotech. We developed CoroFlu vaccine, and that vaccine right now presently undergoing animal trials in Madison, Wisconsin. And this vaccine, once it completes animal talks, animal studies, we will shift it to India and we will start manufacturing in India and going into the human clinical trials in India. We hope the government of India will help us in transiting the project quickly and make it happen, truly make it in India, and that reach to the people of the India and also other part of the world.
However, in reality, the process of a new vaccine launch may take at least 1 to 2 years. For instance, the development involves undertaking animal studies on 2 species as per the Indian regulations. Then the drug control of India has to give permission to make batches of phase 1 studies, and these batches in turn need to be certified by the Central Drugs Laboratory for human use in India. Then comes a phase 2, which includes the dosing studies, and phase 3, which will test the immunogenicity or the ability to trigger an immune response in the body and the efficacy of the vaccine development. Sharing the details about CoroFlu far-reaching collaboration, Dr. Reshes Ella, head of business development at Bharat Biotech, said the company will manufacture the vaccine, conduct clinical trials, and prepare to produce almost 300 million doses of the vaccine for global distribution. Under the collaboration agreement, Flugen will transfer its existing manufacturing process to Bharat Biotech to enable the company to scale up production and produce a vaccine for clinical trials. Refinement of CoroFlu vaccine concept and testing in laboratory models at the University of Wisconsin, Madison is expected to take about 3 to 6 months. The Bharat Biotech unit in Hyderabad, India will then take the production scale up for safety and efficacy testing in humans. CoroFlu could be in human clinical trials by the fall of 2020. Bharat Biotech has been in the forefront in pandemic vaccine development and response. It is the world's leading pandemic vaccine developer from the emergent world. So far, Bharat Biotech has commercialized 16 vaccines, including a vaccine developed for H1N1 flu that caused the 2009 pandemic. 80% of the polio vaccine used in the national immunization in India is supplied by Bharat Biotech. Bharat Biotech is also the world's largest rotavirus vaccine manufacturer. It also developed the world's first type Bar TCV used against typhoid, saving many children from antibiotic-resistant typhoid in developing countries. With a track record of this nature, Bharat Biotech must be very confident that it can produce a vaccine to combat COVID-19 in the shortest possible time, earlier than what the global expert estimate it should take. Thank you for watching.